Bạn đang chỉ tìm một công việc hay một sự nghiệp đầy cơ hội thăng tiến? Bạn hài lòng với những lý thuyết trong sách vở hay muốn tham gia những dự án tầm cỡ thế giới? Bạn thỏa hiệp với một vị trí tạm ổn hay bứt phá để tạo vị thế riêng? HCL, tập đoàn công nghệ hàng đầu thế giới trong 44 năm qua, nay đã đến Việt Nam để giúp bạn kiến tạo tương lai, cùng bạn định hướng sự nghiệp và khai mở tiềm năng từ hôm nay để bạn sẵn sàng lập trình ngày mai. Từ hàng không đến ngân hàng, từ bán lẻ đến y tế, từ dầu khí đến du lịch, vận tải và logistics, HCL đã và đang giúp các đối tác dẫn đầu trong mọi lĩnh vực với những mối quan hệ chiến lược bền vững với hơn 153.000 nhân tài trẻ năng động từ khắp các châu lục, với sản phẩm và dịch vụ tân tiến đáp ứng từng yêu cầu riêng biệt. HCL đã cải tiến các hoạt động của doanh nghiệp tại hơn 55 quốc gia. Giờ đây, bạn hoàn toàn có thể cùng chúng tôi bước tiếp. Gia nhập HCL ngay!
Vâng, xin trân trọng chào đón quý vị đang có mặt tại hội thảo trực tuyến Digital Manufacturing Insight and Opportunities được tổ chức bởi tập đoàn công nghệ HCL Technologies. Đầu tiên, mình xin gửi lời chào và lời chúc sức khỏe, đồng thời cảm ơn sự hiện diện của quý khách trong sự kiện ngày hôm nay. Good morning and welcome to the virtual session Digital Manufacturing Insights and Opportunities organized by HCL Technologies. First of all, I would like to send my greeting and thanks for your presence in today's event. Thưa quý vị, cách mạng công nghiệp 4.0 là thời điểm mang đến sự thay đổi toàn diện cho hệ thống sản xuất. Digital Manufacturing được coi là trái tim của cuộc cách mạng này. Đây là môi trường cho phép máy móc, trang thiết bị có thể tăng hiệu quả sản xuất thông qua tự động hóa và tối ưu hóa. Sự kiện lần này sẽ mang đến những kiến thức chuyên sâu về ứng dụng công nghệ trong lĩnh vực sản xuất và khám phá định hướng của HCL cho công nghệ Xpan 4.0 trong thời gian tới. Industry 4.0 is time to bring comprehensive change to the productions. Digital manufacturing is considered as heart of these revolutions. This environment allows product machines and equipment to increase production efficiencies through automations and cell optimizations. In today's events, we bring in-depth knowledge of technologies application in the manufacturing sector and explore HCL Xpan 4.0. Nếu có câu hỏi, vui lòng comment bên dưới. Chúng tôi sẽ giải đáp tại phiên hội thảo, tại phiên hỏi đáp cuối chương trình. If you have any questions, please comment below. We will answer at the Q&A sessions. Vâng, để bắt đầu thì mình xin mời ông Ravi, Giám đốc phụ trách HCL Việt Nam, có đôi lời phát biểu. To begin, I would like to invite Mr. Ravi, Resident Director of HCL Vietnam, to have a speech, please.
Thank you, Catherine. Xin chào and a very good morning to all. Welcome to the fourth edition of HCL Knowledge Series, where we talk about new technologies, applications in the real world, and opportunities available to learn and build a career around the same. Today's topic is digital manufacturing or Industry 4.0. My name is Ravi. I am the resident director of HCL Vietnam based at Hanoi. I will briefly talk about HCL Technologies, HCL Vietnam, and then hand over to my colleague Vipin to present on today's topic. With this, let me start my presentation. Can we go to the slide, please? Next slide, please. HCL is a 44-year-old global IT services company headquartered in India, and with a revenue of over US$10 billion. We are present in 50 countries. We have an employee base of close to 160,000. We have been ranked as number one in India as the best employer, number 30 globally, and number 5 in the Asia-Pacific region. We have 157 nationalities working for us as on date, and HCL Vietnam happens to be our latest entrant into the HCL family. We have an integrated portfolio of services and products covering IT and business services, engineering and R&D services, IT products and platforms. Engineering and R&D services is an important element for us, and this business is what we are bringing to Vietnam to offer services and opportunities to IT talent to come and join us and work for us. HCL's strategy is based on three pillars called Mode 1, Mode 2, Mode 3, as you can see on the screen. These cover the three key elements, efficiency, agility, and innovation. Across the three strategies that we have, you know, Mode 1, Mode 2, Mode 3 strategies, we cover the entire revenue base of HCL of over $10 billion. Mode 1 talks about application services, infrastructure management services, engineering and R&D services, and digital process operations. Mode 2 is all about the new technology areas in digital and analytics, Internet of Things, cloud native, cybersecurity, and Industry 4.0 is also a part of this. Mode 3 is all about the IT products and platforms that HCL has invested in and is developing and servicing to the global customers. Some of the key industry verticals for us are banking, financial services, insurance, high-tech manufacturing, telecommunication, pharmaceuticals and life sciences, CPG and retail. And these are our focus areas for Vietnam as well. I have already covered this, ranked number one in India, number five in Asia Pacific, including Australia and New Zealand, and ranked number 30 globally as world's best employer. This shows the coverage of HCL from Far East to the West, starting from Japan, going all the way to the West, the Pacific coast of America. Present in 50 countries, 157 nationalities. We have got 220. And we have already set up a global delivery center, which I'll briefly talk about in my subsequent slides. Apart from the delivery centers, we have co-innovation labs that we have invested in. Some of these are innovation labs which HCL has invested in. Some of these are co-innovation labs where we have jointly worked with our strategic customers and partners to develop and offer solutions from these locations. Similarly, we are setting up a couple of such labs and centers of excellence in HCL Vietnam in the high-tech and manufacturing areas as well. This talks about our overall culture, which is very entrepreneurial. We believe in the employee first philosophy, where we believe that if we treat our employees well, they are going to be treating the customers well. So it's a very strategic HR initiative that we have been pursuing for a long time. And this philosophy is also a case study in Harvard Business School, where we call it employee first, customer second. HCL is an innovative company. We have been developing and offering solutions for so many years. And these solutions have been taken to the market and jointly developed with some of our strategic partners and customers as well. And we believe in outcome-based delivery. What we commit to our strategic customers, we deliver. And these three boxes cover our overall focus for HCL as an innovative company, which is offering services globally. Our focus for Vietnam is very clear. We on the blue, on the left side in blue, are the industry verticals where we are focusing on. As I mentioned, banking, financial services, retail, CPG, automobiles, manufacturing, pharmaceutical, medical devices. On the right side in gray boxes are the IT services that we are going to be delivering from Vietnam, which includes applications and SI services, which means application management, application development, software development, and support. We have the engineering and R&D services, IT infrastructure management services, IT products and platforms, and some of the captives that we are working on with our strategic partners to service from Vietnam. The focus for HCL Vietnam is threefold, where we deliver our services to global customers in the US and Europe and in other regions. We also deliver services to our regional customers in the APAC region, including Australia and New Zealand. And finally, HCL Vietnam for Vietnam, where we are engaged in some of our discussions with the local customers who want services from our side, and we'll be delivering it from here. Apart from doing Vietnam, we are looking at Korea, Taiwan, and Japan delivery as well from Vietnam. With this, I would like to hand over to my colleague Vipin to start his presentation on today's topic, which is Industry 4.0 or digital manufacturing. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. Good morning. Let me introduce myself. My name is Vipin Kumar Gehlot. I am a digital manufacturing and Industry 4.0 solutioning lead. And we are in HCL. I am responsible for making the strategy for the go-to-market or in this space for the that is digital manufacturing and Industry 4.0. So just let me give some brief background about myself. I have almost 20-year experience of the manufacturing, which is and global automotive manufacturing. Prior to HCL, I work with automotive global automotive manufacturing in as a manufacturing engineering lead and a digital transformation initiative like plant automations, robotic simulations, process automations, this kind of the activities. In HCL, I am leading the digital transformation and Industry 4.0. In this space, we are providing the services to our customer globally in US, Europe, and Asia Pacific, where we are enabled to our customer for digital transformations. Today in this webinar, for Vietnam, the agenda for this. First, we cover Industry 4.0 overview and challenges. What are the challenges enterprises are facing? Then we discuss. We'll talk about digital manufacturing. That is our brand, HCL own brand, the Expand 4.0. Then we have some case studies. We have some market view. How this industry is growing globally, and then some of our point of view and how. What is our approach to implementing Industry 4.0 and digital transformation across the enterprises and manufacturing? Then we discuss the career growth for especially for the Vietnam, how a workforce can grow in this space and what are the talents are required, and then some of the key takeaways from this today webinar. Please go to the next slide. Yes. Next. So when we're talking about the overview and then digital transformation journey from the 3.0 to 4.0, actually Industry 3.0 just is the vertical integration across the enterprises. Like if we talk about manufacturing processes, so where product is not connecting to the manufacturing, if we talk about 3.0, only the processes, equipment, and devices are connecting to each other. That is, these are the drawback of 3.0. And there is a automation like PLC, robotic automation, plant simulation, these are things is there. But these things is not sufficient for today environment. Because today, everybody talking about the digital transformations. So Industry 4.0, it is a holistic approach. And everyone, is following this approach, and where we can connect the product. There's a smart product. Smart product is being connected to the manufacturing. That called smart factory. In smart factory, there's a vertical integration of the processes. There's a horizontal integration processes, and machine to machine communication is there. Process to process communication is there, where we can visualize the processes, we can monitor, we can control, even we can control the process from the remote location also. And then smart product, smart factory is connecting to the outside world, that is called connected world. So in HCL, we have the holistic approach for the Industry 4.0 implementation, which is driven of our consulting lead and technology driven. So this time, this is the evaluation. Yes. So here is overview. Overview, we can, what is actual Industry 4.0? Industry 4.0 is the intelligent integration of the physical cyber system. Like here, we are leveraging the technologies like upcoming emerging technologies like digital twin, 5G, AR, VR, automation, plant automation, MES. So these are the emerging technologies for the manufacturing. That is, we are enabling this technology. We are leveraging this technology to implementing Open Industry 4.0. So if we talk about where it is implemented, it is discrete manufacturing and the process industry as well. So like I will use the example here, discrete manufacturing like car automotive manufacturing plant, where thousand of the car is being produced every day, and there's a huge automation of the robotic automation, plant to plant communications, process being monitored and visualized from the remote location, and the process is shown on the dashboard also. So this is one example for the discrete manufacturing. Same way, the Industry 4.0 can be implemented in the process industries. Like process industries, for example, process pharma industries, CPG industries, and chemical manufacturing, and the paint manufacturing as well. So next question is coming, why the Industry 4.0 and what are the challenges? This process actually is a change management. So where we are changing from 3.0 to 4.0, so there's some challenges also is there. And this is a transformation in the digital world. And manufacturing are moving towards this digital world, digital connected, that where they're calling the factory as a smart factory, digital factory, where they can connect to each other, process can connect to each other. This kind of the process is this have. Next slide. So now, when change is happening in the industries, change management is happening anywhere, there's some challenges is there. Same way, in Industry 4.0 also some few challenges is there, like how to make the strategy, how to make the investment, how much investment we have to make, like which kind of the data is required, then how to overcome the cyber securities, and how to make the business cases. So definitely everywhere the challenges is there, but we at CL having the we are enable to our customer to overcome these challenges, because this is our DNA. And we have the almost more than a 20-year experience of the engineering R&D services, which is driven on the consulting-led and the technology-led. So here we can help our customer to enterprises to overcome of these challenges and smoothly is implementing of the Industry 4.0 concept. Next slide. So now I explain in my agenda, now we'll talk about expand our brand. This is our brand for Industry 4.0. This is like I talk about experience. We have the more than 20-year experience of engineering R&D services. So this brand, it talk about experience powered by analytics and data insights. Because without data, we cannot do anything. Data is the fuel for anyway, for anything. So the data is, when this data is being analyzed, it gives some insights, and we are putting our experience and then we are generating the insights. So this is expand is talk about, we are enabling our customer to connect with the processes, to connect with the plant, and create the value from silo in the siloed engineering manufacturing, and even after sales market functions also. So this is our framework. where we are enabled to build this connect, collaborate to each other, and provide the value to our customers. This is our DNA, which is led by consulting and technology driven. So in summary, Expand 4.0, like I talked about, explain experience powered by analytics and data. So what we are doing here, we are connecting to the enterprises, we are connecting to the vendors, we are connecting to the processes, procurement, sales, marketing, manufacturing, and design. Everything is together and providing the value to the customers. So here we are our approach is, we are leveraging our brand, our Expand 4.0 framework that enabled to develop the blueprint of the transformation, where we build the enterprises to connect and enable them to collaborations and optimize their processes. Because when they optimize their processes, they are able to improve their efficiency, operation efficiencies. That is, nothing is KPIs. KPIs in terms of the delivery, productivity improvement, capacity improvement, quality improvement, cost reduction, and of course, safety and sustainability is the part of the KPIs. So here then, why HCL is required, is there? HCL, like I've explained, HCL is the like Ravi also explained in earlier, we are the number one in India, and we have the footprint across to the globe. And so this is our strong DNA to coupled with the enterprises and our partner and our customers, and to provide, to give the consulting and consulting services, and which is technology driven. That is our approach for implementing this type of the concept globally. Yes, thanks. Now we'll talk about the market size, how this industry is growing. So already maybe you have seen somewhere, you have seen the articles that this industry is growing $140 billion by 2024. So there's the growth rate of 37%, that is compounded annual growth rate. It's 37% annual growth is there. So is in this space, in this market, there's a huge benefit and huge opportunity is there for the customer also, plus for the service provider also. We can see in center, there's a, in the yellow box is the some of the use cases we have shown here. So just this year, these are the use cases where enterprise can adopt these use cases, and they can get the benefits by implementing of these use cases. And right side, we can see the which use case is having the what, how much potential, and then what is the growth rate for year and year. So this is industry is very growing industries, and there's a huge opportunity is available over there. Next slide. Now we can see the adoption of a market view and adoptions. So adoption by region in North America is adopting these technologies very highly. Then Europe also is very high, and then Asia Pacific also is implementing of these technologies. We can see the vertical. Customers like Tesla, GE, Siemens, ABB. These companies already is working on these to implementing these technologies. If we want to see the adoption by the technologies, almost there the 17 technology is there. That technology is vary from the customer to customer, enterprise to enterprise. But by implementing these technologies, we can showcase our industry as a smart industries, a digital factory. So these are the technologies which we being adopted by the enterprises. And if you see the vertical wise, automotive is higher to who's implementing these technology and this concept of industry 4.0. Then others industry as well, metal, mining, and then energy, these industries is very adopting of these technologies very faster. Okay. Next slide, please. Anand? Anand? Okay, now we'll talk about point of view. Industry 4.0 point of view. How, what is our point of view for this domain? So this slide is, looks like busy slide, but I will try to explain very in a simple way. So left side, we can see the enterprises, like where enterprise is connecting shop floor to top floor. Like shop floor is nothing, just manufacturing plant, process where product is being processed. Then it is connecting, is controlling by the supervisor, manager, and then collecting by controlling by the plant manager, and then the top management is there. This is the vertical integrations. But when we're talking about the horizontal integration, this is where engineering function, product design and engineering function, that is connecting to the manufacturing, and then it's connecting to the expense. Expense is the market and product service, sales and services. So this blue box circle, you can see the integration across life cycle. So here in horizontal integration, we are doing the integration across engineering life cycle. We are doing the integration across manufacturing life cycle and experience, that is product sales and services. So by doing this integration, vertical and horizontal integration, then we can see we are able to use some offering from that, from this. This offering is a digital design where product being designed and developed. Then digital manufacturing where product is being manufactured. I give the example like process industries, and then products, digital products and services where products being services and sales and after sales markets. So of this there's a business outcome is there. Business outcome is just growth. Every enterprise's growth is there. Efficiency improvement is there. Valuation is there. And then lower risk is there. Of course, sustainability and safety also is a part of the outcome of this complete ecosystem. So this is simple, our concept and our point of view. Which we are explaining to our customer, and customer is highly adopting this concept because here is everything is connecting to each other, and they are able to see the growth in this growth areas for like operational efficiencies and KPI improvement. Next slide. Yes, so again further is how it's getting implemented. We can see then centered industry 4.0 in circle, and there's a customization, productivity, and then competitiveness is there. So these three factors is connecting to each other. Then there's the product data, is the operation data and ecosystem data, and then customer data, which is connecting to the each other, and is connect data is coming from these areas. Anand, can you click one time more? Okay, yes, please, thank you. No, go back, yes. So when this data is coming from and is coming to the product data, is being integrated to each other, then it is generate some insights. Black, you can see the insights, that this data is being analyzed and then is give some insights. And then this data is connecting to the outside world experience. Like OE improvement, operational efficiency improvement, safety, which may be the quality, which may be the user experience, and which maybe is the customizations, productivity, product improvement, and product developments. So this is the concept where and how we are implementing this PowerPoint, the point of view, and to this our point of view we are using for the digital transformation concept. Yes, next. So then here further, we have some in this capability and offering an impact. How is giving the impact all over to the enterprises? Like it below, you can see the technologies areas. So these are some technologies involved in this and some service area like PLM, MES, MOM, Edge, platform, automation, infrastructure. Then solution accelerator is there. And then partnership ecosystem is there. When this all is connecting to each other, then it is connected intelligent way, securing the data and in the agile framework. Then these are supported by our three categories, which is digital design, digital manufacturing, and product and services. Then it gives the impact. Impact is the valuation of the valuation drivers, growth driver, and efficiency drivers. These are the impact is providing by this complete ecosystem. Yes, next slide. So then we have the offering list, but these are not limited. This is only indicative, but we have the multiple offering in this domain, which we are implementing to our customer, and customer is adopting these offerings highly demanding offering. These are yes, next. So just here I will explain this digital framework, digital manufacturing framework. So you might be seeing how the digital manufacturing is connecting. So there's the ISA 95 controller architecture automation layer is there. Is layer like yellow is left side, L1 and L2 is automation layer, where controlled devices and field instrument are connecting, like PLC, smart HMI, SCADA, then smart sensor, smart meters, smart devices are is there. These are connecting to the next automation layer is L2, L3 through the IT-OT integrations. So here is the IT and OT integration is there. That is helping to connect to the next level. That is MES, and plant operation and execution, where we can customize according to our process requirement. And then in this way, we are connect to multiple plant. If the enterprise is having the multiple plant across the globe, then they are able to connect this plant by using this concept, this framework. And this is then connecting to the upper level, that is called enterprise level, that is called control automation layer 4, where SAP, ERP, PLM, and then CRM, these are connecting to each other. So we can see here, there's a horizontal integration is there, there's a vertical integration is there. So this is our concept and framework for the digital manufacturing, and that called the Industry 4.0. And few a customer is calling the smart factory, digital factory, but all is the same. That is that concept is all over the Industry 4.0. Next. So then we have the partnership ecosystem, and we have categorized our partner in the different layer. Like as I discussed about automation layer, different layer is there. Same way is the for embedded and sensor and smart devices level, we have the partnership list. And when we are talking about IT/OT integration, then we have the specified partner in for the domain. Then when we are talking about the digital product innovation PLM, then we have the specified partners. So this is a complete ecosystem of the partners. Next. Then HCL, like Ravi explained, this HCL is recognized various and vertical platforms. Like this is the Everest analytics company is recognized us to in the digital manufacturing domain, and we are almost in four number top five everywhere, every domain category. Yes, thanks. Then we can see the technical path growing, how the career growth in this domain, especially for in Vietnam, how the workforce, the talent can grow in this domain, like from the from mechanical and electrical and electronics engineer to the control engineer, the next level industrial plant supervisor, digital manufacturing and transformation lead, and then they will become an industry 4.0 lead. So these are the career path of a technical role in the digital manufacturing. And right side, you can see what are the skills are required in this domain, like analytics, AI, ML, data engineering, big data, cloud analytics, digital twin, and IoT cloud platform. So these are the technologies and skills are required for this technical part. Next. Next slide, please. Yes, so here few key takeaway which we have understood in this today's webinar, like digital manufacturing overview, overview, and what is the digital industry 4.0 and how and where is being implemented and how HCL is supporting in this domain to our customers. Then exposure of the various domain on the in the digital manufacturing. We talk about discrete manufacturing. We talk about process industries, how we are able to implement. Then type of the role and career growth in this space, and opportunity within the field of the in the digital manufacturing. There's a huge opportunity in this domain, and there's opportunities available at every level, from start to end. There's opportunities available in everywhere and every space. And how do I leap the digital manufacturing would be the career growth domain for everyone, where the people then can grow, and then they can learn, they can implement, they can accept this, they can use their experience in this, and then became the part of the our idea dependency culture for the which is HCL strong culture for the industries. I think this is over from my side. No, we talk about if anybody has no questions, we can discuss, we can take, we along with Ravi and other team, we can discuss the question here.
Thank you, Vipin, for your presentations. Vâng, và phần chia sẻ vừa rồi cũng đã khép lại nội dung chính của chương trình ngày hôm nay. Tiếp theo đây xin mời đến phần Q&A. Nếu các bạn có bất kỳ thắc mắc nào, hãy vui lòng để lại câu hỏi ở dưới phần comment. Chúng mình sẽ happy to answer. And this sharing also closed the main topic of our event today. So now let's move on to the Q&A sessions. Vipin, we have one question from Mrs. Le. What difficulties do the production phase need to apply digital?
Please, can you repeat the question?
What difficulties do the production phase need to apply digitals?
Yes, I think it's very relevant and very good questions who's asking. I think it's very important questions. There's some difficulties, definitely, because when we are talking about the implementing of the digital transformation production areas. So there's a difficulty like how to collect the data. First, we have to develop, we have to see, is our platform is the develop as a digital, is the digital. So we have to make first our platform as a digital infrastructure. So when we make the digital infrastructure, then we have to able to connect this infrastructure to the next level of automations. So difficulty is first how to collect the data, how to do the analysis of this data, because data will come from the smart equipment. So you should have the smart equipment, smart devices like sensor, humidity sensor, temperature sensor. So these smart devices you should have. And then you are able to connect these devices to the next level. So difficulty is this, first we have to make our infrastructure as a digital. And then after making this infrastructure digital, then we are able to connect these to the next and multiple layer of the automations. Of course, there are other difficulties also. We have to train the people. The workforce should be skilled and re-skilled. We have to give the trainings to them. We have to make the proper roadmap for implementing of the industry 4.0. And that in this roadmap, we have to talk about the how to implement and where to implement, which business case we have to adopt, which business case is the higher return of investment, and which business case is more investment. So there will be less ROI. So that's we have to think about. That's why we have the consulting approach. First, we are consulting with our customer and with the enterprises to consult with them and we are doing the workforce, like one day workshop, 2 day workshop with our technical team, and we analyze their processes. And after analyze their process, we suggest to them, okay, these are the things you have to do. And by doing these are the things, then you can get operational efficiency improvement in XY area. So like this we are doing.
Thank you for your answers. Vâng, và cảm ơn tất cả các diễn giả của chúng tôi ngày hôm nay, và cảm ơn các bạn khán giả đã ngồi lại đến cuối chương trình. Mình biết rằng là có rất nhiều câu hỏi cần được giải đáp, tuy nhiên do thời lượng của chương trình có hạn, vậy nên ban tổ chức sẽ trả lời những câu hỏi còn lại qua email. Trước khi kết thúc, hãy dành khoảng 2 phút để hoàn thiện feedback form với những phản hồi của các bạn, rất là quan trọng đối với chúng tôi để là tiền đề để nâng cao chất lượng của những buổi hội thảo tiếp theo. Thanks to our speakers and attendees who stayed with us until now. I know that there still have a lot of questions that need to be answered, but time is limited, so we will answer the remaining question to email. Before closing, please complete the feedback form sharing in the chat box. Your feedback is very important to us for the quality improvement in the next seminars. Mình hy vọng rằng buổi hội thảo ngày hôm nay sẽ mang lại những kiến thức bổ ích cũng như giúp các bạn định hướng được tương lai. Nếu như các bạn quan tâm đến các cơ hội việc làm tại SCL Việt Nam, vui lòng truy cập scvietnam.com để xem các vị trí đang tuyển dụng. So I hope that today's event will bring you useful knowledge as well as help you save your futures. If you have interested in career opportunities at SCL, please visit scvietnam.com to find out our available job. Và một lần nữa thì mình xin cảm ơn các vị khách quý đã dành thời gian tham dự chương trình và chúc mọi người một cuối tuần tràn đầy niềm vui và ý nghĩa. Thank you to attending our virtual sessions with your very joyful weekends and goodbye.